You know, that's kind of unfortunate, but we do have two events that are going on that we could be looking at. And you probably saw one of them developing this morning. I did as I came into work low on the western horizon. You saw the moon. It was large and it was yellow. It was kind of neat to see. But this is the August full moon that's going to be taking place Thursday night. And then, or actually, yeah, Thursday night is when we're looking, and that's going to be when it's going to peak, is in the evening. So it's also a supermoon. This is the fourth in a row. We had a supermoon in May, in June, in July, and now in August. And so, I mean, they're not unusual, but it does make for a brighter moon. It makes for a larger moon, 6% larger, about 16% brighter in the sky than your average moon. That's going to offset the other event that's going to be taking place, because it's going to be a bright moon Friday night and into Saturday. That's when we have the Perseid meteor shower at its peak. So if you're going to be looking for the meteors associated with the meteor shower there, look towards the northeast near Cassiopeia, which is kind of like a wonky W in the sky if you kind of connect the dots of that constellation. Best time for viewing is going to be, of course, after the sun goes down. But you want to wait a little bit longer as it gets darker in the sky. You want to find a nice dark spot. But again, you're going to be up against the moon. But we could see in some spots 25 to 100 per hour. But again, unfortunately, because the moon's going to be so bright, the number's probably going to be about cut in half. But that's the direction to look. And the good news is, though, is that the Perseid meteor shower also is pretty big on putting up what's called fireballs. And so typically when you have the meteors coming through the atmosphere burning up, they're about the size of grains of sand. Well, this one has an abnormal number of ones that are maybe the size of Skittles, so they're a little bit bigger, and so they leave a brighter light, and so they're easier to see in the night sky. So that's something that we have to look forward to. So that's the latest with what's going on in the skies. Now let's get back to weather.